Welcome to PDFsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing a 9030 CPU, specifically the IC693CPU364. As I've mentioned before, don't worry about the revision letters after the 364. All tests will be the same. It's a troubleshooting test. I'm using a 5-slot base rack, IC693CHS397, and a IC693PWR330 power supply. We're going to go ahead and power it up. And the first thing I'm going to look for, if this is a troubleshooting, testing the CPU, is that I have an OK light. If you don't have an OK light, you need to stop right here. It's OK if it's blinking and then it turns solid, but you have to have a light there. Okay. Now that it's connected and it's powered up, we're going to open a blank test file I have here in Proficy Machine Edition. I'm going to go ahead and open up the rack within the software, and it should show the 397 rack I mentioned, the power 330, and the CPU 364. I don't have any other modules in here because this is just an isolated test on the CPU. Now that that's correct, I'm going to go ahead and connect up to it using this lightning bolt icon in the top left corner of the screen. You'll see this pulsing here. This means that the computer is talking to the controller through the power supply. And then this green handprint, I'm going to click that. That takes me, if you look at the bottom here, the programmer mode, stop, disabled, that's the outputs, and configuration not equal, logic not equal, which is correct. We're not downloaded yet. So next you want to go to target, to online commands, and we want to clear any controller faults, I/O faults. Don't clear all memory and don't clear any of these other memories that could affect the performance of your CPU. Go ahead and click OK. Yes. Now that those faults are clear, I'm going to go ahead and download and run. The first thing it's going to ask us is what we want to download for this test, just hardware configuration and motion and logic. We're going to go ahead and hit OK. We don't want to put any other values in. Yes, we want to enable the outputs. Now at this time, the controller is not going to start. You're going to see an error in the feedback zone at the bottom. The controller is not in run mode after you attempted to start it. This may be due to a run-stop switch position, which is correct. I want to just test that this memory protect switch is working. When I turn it on, the CPU should be in run mode, both on the controller indicated by this LED and on the software, programmer run enabled. So now that that's okay, that's the first part that we know that the CPU can get into run mode. And I'm going to go ahead and open up this configuration to show you guys something on the Ethernet. This is a test file I have already created, and I've created it with an IP address here that doesn't conflict with anything, any other devices that are configured on our network here at work, with a subnet mask. And the reason for that is because I want to test the Ethernet card. The first thing I want to do is I usually test this 10 base T, the direct Ethernet port. I have a plug here. It's connected to our network. And I've got this command prompt. If you guys don't know what that is, it's if you go to the start screen, you should have a command prompt either right on the menu or when you open up your accessories. So I'm going to enter the address, ask it to ping. Now once this LAN LED is blinking, I know I've got a solid connection between the network and the Ethernet card. Hit enter. It's going to ping it 4 times. all four results all within the same time period. 4 out of 4 is good. Next thing I want to do is use, which some of you guys may have, an AAUI port. So we'll take the local cable, plug it into the AAUI transceiver, and plug it into this port on the front of the CPU. Again, same thing, you want to make sure that the LAN LED is blinking. And I'm going to just hit the up key, and that's going to bring the same address and the same command that I did last time. Go ahead and hit enter. And same thing, 4 out of 4 pings, all good. So the next thing I'm going to test is I'm going to test it without any information going to either port. And the reason I want to do that is because I want to test to make sure that I'm not pinging another device that somebody set up with the same address. Go ahead and hit the up key, hit enter, and what I'm hoping for is no reply. Request timed out. And it should say that 4 times in a row. And once it has, I know that I've not pinged anything else. And that's pretty much a full test. Another thing that I would recommend, if you do think that you're having problems with the CPU, if it's, you know, something when your back is turned, you have problems, set it up in this configuration that I've shown you. Leave it in run mode. Leave it overnight. Leave it over a weekend. And see if it pops out of run mode. It shouldn't. But if it does, you want to, if it's stopped and it looks like this, no run light, and down below it says stop disabled, go into target, online commands, or rather diagnostics. And in the fault table, it'll tell you exactly what's going on, what happened. In this particular case, there's no real fault. These are just telling me that there was no program present in the controller, which is true. It's just a blank controller. It's a blank file. We know that, so I can clear that out. But if there was any real problems, it would list it in here, and then you can expand on it by clicking it, and it can give you more description, more detail. So I hope this helps you guys out. Thank you.